So how much does ham radio cost? Now, this is a broad subject. This is actually at the beginning of the foundation book. But I mean, you don't have to be studying for foundation to understand how much ham radio costs. There's materials and information. And it goes on about the cost of equipment. So this is technically part two of the foundation license. But I've got my own opinions on this, and I think that's important to have an opinion. All right, so where do we start? Okay, so if you live on a fairly high point, you know, 1,000 feet, or just above the rest of your terrain, you'd be lucky. You might be able to get away with a little handheld radio. My personal experience, I have literally 7 or 8 handheld radios. The only time I ever use them is if someone's on the farm, you know, another amateur, and I'm doing something, you know, in the antenna field, and they're in the shack, and it saves me making a phone call, frankly. The rest of the time, I've found it a complete and utter waste of time. The only time that a handheld radio can be of any benefit is when you're up on a high point, and it's a weekend when people have actually got their sets on, all right? Then you will hear and be able to communicate and do a bit more traffic. Then one other thing you might be able to do is use a repeater. Okay, so now you can go on, if you just do a Google search for repeater lists in your area. So if you're in the US, do a repeater list near, I don't know, New York or something. But fundamentally, how that works is that in general terms, there's a hill and there's going to be a tower here with some other contraptions and baloney on it. And the repeater keeper, or a bunch of guys and gals, got together and decided to put a little antenna on top. And they probably paid some money to do that, and they've got a feed and that sort of thing. And you're down here with your little walkie-talkie thing, and it picks it up there, and it rebroadcasts it everywhere. And you can get amazing coverage that way. So if you have got a repeater locally, you might find a handheld can come in handy. I don't want to labour the point, but I just don't want what to say to you. Don't over... what's the word? Overestimate. Some people think, oh, I've got a walkie-talkie, I can talk around the world. You're not going to be able to, and it might be a great disappointment, okay? You can spend £20 or £30 or dollars and get a cheap thing just to have a play and then make your mind up. But anyway, so let's put a line under the walkie-talkie thing. There's plenty of people on YouTube that do videos about walkie-talkies and stuff. So what do we really need then? Okay, so you might have heard an expression called shack in a box, and that's basically a radio with a big knob on the front. We call that the VFO, and a display and lots of buttons, okay? And fundamentally, that will do everything. It's called a shack in a box. It literally does everything. So on the one hand, we've got normally from 1.8 megahertz, which is what we call top band, or 160 meter band, up to most HF radios now. I'll stand by for the shack of the box in a minute. We'll go up to either the 10 meter band, 28 to 29 megahertz, or 50 megahertz, what they call the 6 meter band. So it goes to 10, I'm using frequencies here. From 1.8 to 28, or 50-ish megahertz. That's HF. And then VHF, a shack in a box, will also add on to that somewhere around 145 megahertz, depending what country in the world. US goes up to 146, 147. We stop at 145, unless we've got something called a notice of variation. And we've got the 70 centimeters band, which is on or about 433 megahertz. So a shack in a box will do all that relatively well. Okay, so my first shack in the box, I think, was something called a TS-2000. It operated very well, good enough. Under contest conditions, I found some foibles about it, but that was a shack in a box. Excuse me. So just stand by here, right? So the other thing we can do is, I'll go blue. is instead of buying a big thing, you can buy a mobile, what they call a mobile radio. It's a bit smaller, okay, and it might not have a knob on it, it might just have buttons, but it'll have a display. And in the main, that will be doing, normally, most mobile radios will do the 2 meter band and or the 70 centimeter band. So that's around at about 145 and 430-ish, depending which part of the world you're in. And they're good fun. That means that you can plug that into your car, but then on top of your car, I'm not very good at drawing cars, I'm sure. But on top of your car, you'll normally need a little antenna to plug that into. And I'll just do all the costs in a minute. Right. So if we bought a Shack in the Box now, or an HF radio, so something along these lines here, what else are we going to need? So we've got our radio, which I'll just write radio. We're going to need a power supply. We can't plug it straight into the mains. Most HF radios, apart from the really huge things, plug straight in the wall, will need a little power supply, what we call a PSU. PSU, power supply unit. So that plugs into the mains, all right? And then we've got 13.8 volts, which will fire up the radio. So we need a power supply. So let's just imagine we've either gone down a Shack in a Box, or we're going down, that's this one here, or we're going down an HF radio, shortwave, okay? Doesn't matter, the same thing applies here. However, pick a different colour. Once we've got that, we need an antenna. So if it is a Shack in the Box, well, it doesn't really matter. Let's just go HF for our shortwave. We're going to need a piece of coax out to our backyard or our back garden or whatever with an antenna at the end of it, which I'll come to in a minute. Same with your 2 meter thing, because you could have a mobile radio next to this, right, dedicated to 2 and 70, and that can be quite an economical way of doing things. So you can buy a fairly old, maybe with a warranty on it, radio here, and get yourself a fairly nice 2 meter VHF UHF rig for this. We call it a rig, it's a radio. However, that's going to need coax as well, and that's going to need its dedicated antenna, because if you remember, amateur radio, or the whole HF spectrum, is a little bit about the whole HF spectrum, it's a little bit like a grand piano. So each string on a grand piano is a different length. It's got a different note. Okay, so if we're playing a note, right, we're on the 40 meter band, which is on or about 7 megahertz plus. So we got 7 megahertz, small m actually. Is it megahertz? Big M. I was right. 7 megahertz. We will need a particular antenna which will tune to that band, which is going to be completely different to our VHF antenna. Now, if you talk to a dealer about this, but invest, if you're going down the 2 meter 70 cems route, then you need to invest some serious money in your coax. Otherwise, you'll be into terrible losses. Okay. Really terrible losses. So I'm giving you the picture so far. So let me put some prices on stuff. So I'm on the Martin Lynch site at the moment, which is hamradio.co.uk. And I just selected Yaesu. It could have been Kenwood, it could have been Icom, it could have been anybody. But let's just, for the hell of it, I mean, I'm not Yaesu man, I'm not being paid by Martin Lynch to do this. I'm just having a bit of fun, okay? And I think it might be in price order, I don't know. No, it's not. So there's a little FT840 here for £375. There's an FT920. That was actually quite a good radio in its day, I seem to remember. Over there, a 950, you know. And at the end of the day, you can see what the prices are. We're starting off at £375 here. That's probably over 20 years old, by the way. But it doesn't matter. It was probably still work. Well, of course it still work. You're buying it off a dealer. I think it's a great price, actually. For, you know, like your first little radio. So let's put some prices, okay? And we'll just mark them down. A mobile rig What are we going to expect you to pay? We've got an HF radio and we've got a shack in the box.
Radio.
We'll need some coax and connectors, a power supply and other odds and ends. Now, I've got to say, I was down getting a takeaway from the restaurant at the bottom of the road and I met a really keen fisherman. He was very, very keen fisherman. And I said to him, it's interesting. I said, because I made a video the other day where I compared amateur radio, what I do, with fishing. Right? And someone's after me. And I said to him that my gut feeling is that to get into my hobby in a pleasurable manner, where, you know, you've got the right sort of toys and everything else, is probably, the minimum is probably about £1,000. May I ask how much it would cost to get into your hobby? You know, once you've got your little chair and your umbrellary thing and your, you know, a fishing rod and a spool and line and boxes and everything else. And he scratched his head for about 30 seconds. He went, you know what, I reckon a minimum's about £1,000. I mean, he probably spends more than that, a lot more than that, as I do, because, you know, I started off light and then started investing. So roughly, what would I say we need to pay for all this? So your mobile radio, now, I don't know. I don't know. I just don't know. Let's have a quick look. Mobile radio. Let's just have a look at a regular amateur radio, mobile radio. Here we go. Let's have a look at your average Joe. I don't know. I'll pick Yaesu again. Could be Kenwood. Could be Icon, by the way. That's fine. A nice sort of dual band. There's a 2 meter only, 80 watts output. FT2980 Echo. So it does one thing very well, okay? And that's probably great for the car, if you've got a license for 80 watts, £149. And you can go down the second-hand market as well. So if you've got a nice 2 meter rig in the car, 80 watts, that's lovely. So let's make a note of that. That's brand new as well, £149. By the way, we're going to need a little antenna, right, for your car. And I'm guessing we probably need to add £50. Okay, so into 200. But you could use that inside, right, with your little power supply in your house. But you've got to invest in the coax, right? And we've got coax here. HF radio, I would suggest if you budgeted around £400 to £500. We'll go low rather than high because we have seen one at £379, £400. Or we can go down a shack in a box route. Now that is going to be more expensive. It just is. Amateur radio. Go down the base station route. We'll pick Yaesu again because I'm not a Yaesu man. I know they do a couple of little shack in a boxes which are quite nice. Brand new this is. They did do him. What, a 991A? Yeah, here we are. 991A. That does everything quite well. In fact, Hayden over at Ham Radio DX in Tasmania, he likes this radio. He wished he'd never got rid of it. And it's got a USB port for your sound card. So this would do everything. So I'm not going to write it down, but a shack in a box, brand new. You're looking at £1,200. Probably roughly the same in dollars. So, I mean, I'll write it down here. Second hand, you get it for less. TS2000's going for about £950. Whatever. Coax, right. The minimum coax I would personally go with would be something like Ultraflex 7. And a roll of that is quite expensive. boom, boom, boom. I'm sure we can buy 100 meter reel of that. I'm going to put down 150 for 100 meter reel, add on about another 20 or so pounds for the connectors. Now, I've just done a video about putting connectors on this coax. So you're into with a nice four connectors, okay? One for HF, one for VHF, because you know. Need to do that. I'll put 175. I'll just put 175. Power supply, I've got no idea. I don't know. power supply. I can't believe they want this much money for a power supply, to be honest. You need to go second hand for your power supply. It'll last forever. I'm going to put £50 down, because I wouldn't pay that. That's all. This assumes you already have a little laptop or an old computer knocking around. You don't need something super powerful. Okay, that'll be fine. So we're into 200, 600, 775. Oh, okay. Well, I reckon we've done that for about 850, which in the US is about $1,000. You're going to need something like a V2000. V2000. Diamond and your antenna, £114 for a diamond V2000, beautiful antenna. You'll need to, it's £100, okay? And you either get the ladder out yourself and the pole and some TNK brackets and put it up, or pay £50 and get a little man around and do it. By the way, I'm not interested in what HF antenna you're putting out here, because I think you should just do something like a fan dipole or a basic dipole. I'm sure I've done videos about that. That's going to cost you £10 and get you on, let's say, 40 metres and 20 metres to kick the ball off, all right, and kick you off going. Enjoy your ham radio hobby and don't spend too much money. And whatever you do, don't tell your partner how much you've really spent. Okay? Bye for now.